Now, always making known his voice to his people by his prophet sign. I'm talking about Moses. That's where I'm banking back, and then see where we're at. God's word is manifested by the voice of the sign. Now, the sign that is promised for the day is done before the people, and then the written scripture comes forth is the voice of that sign. If it doesn't give a scriptural voice, then stay away from it. See? It's not God. Because God can't promise this for today and say, oh, this is it. See? God cannot do that. God cannot promise something for one day and say, no, I won't do that. That was for another day. What he promises, he must stay with it. Amen. And the real scriptural sign is the scriptural voice. Moses' sign that he saw was God in cosmic light. And then when he did that, and did anybody know the old Hebrew sign, even before there was a Bible written, was a triangle shape or oval shape of a cosmic light? Exactly right, the Logos. Now, Dr. Lonsdale has that in his Bible on the cover on the outside. Now, we notice that Moses was attracted by this sign, and this sign spoke to Moses with a scriptural voice. See? Amen. The sign attracted him, and then he said, I remember my promise, and I've come down to deliver them, and I'm going to use you for a mouthpiece. You go on down there. Moses made his excuses, but God sent him anyhow. Now, that's his way of interpreting his word. A prophet in the scripture must first be a seer that's a vindicator. It must not be just any fellow come along and say, I got thus saith the Lord, and next and say, I see thus saith the Lord. Prophets are not hands laid on them and made prophets. Prophets are predestinated for the hour. The Bible tells when they'll come, what they'll be. Prophets are sent from God. They're offices of God that's been born. God told Jeremiah, before you was even conceived in your mother's womb, I ordained you a prophet to the nation.
Amen.
They're just, that must be perfectly in the man. It's not him, it's a gift from him. Moses was born a prophet. Jeremiah was born a prophet. Isaiah, a prophet. John the Baptist, a prophet.
Amen.
God has spoken of them. And what they say must be true. And the way that the people is to know whether they are true or not, what he says must be correct, because what he's prophesying about is his credentials of his call from God when God vindicates what he says to be the truth. Now that's why I'm trying to say these things tonight, so that you'll understand. Now, if the Bible said over here, if there be one among you who's spiritual or a prophet, I, the Lord, will make myself known unto him in visions, speak to him through dreams. Then he says, if this prophet says anything, and it doesn't happen, then don't you believe it. Now, that's no more than good sense. But if what he says comes to pass, then hear, then you must fear him because he's with you.